Greetings and salutations, everyone, live from the Ruchi's room here on the Dark Side of the Moon. This is the Loophole King. Glad everybody could be here. We are just going to be doing some plain old D&D prep. Hey, Mind's Eye, how's it going, buddy? If you're a buddy, I just call everybody buddy. My mic is so in the way today. I don't know what the problem is. It is having some major malfunction issues here. Oh, just getting ready to get my finale done here. I have one regular session left and two episodes of the finale and epilogue to get done for this campaign that's been going on for 3.5 years now. So, it's kind of a bittersweet ending. Going to be, they're like squirrels. They have the hey look squirrels problem, where most of the side quests are not integral to the main plot. They're just stuff that they started and never actually either turned in or got distracted by some of the major plot points that they were kind of like on a timetable to do, because they dilly-dallied around. But lots of good world building. Oh, the main plot is coming to an end. Oh no, they're very, very, very interested, motivated to do this. These players are very, the main plot is very integral to their storylines for their characters, and they have worked their way up to, this is like the final boss fight and stuff, so, everybody knows that it's the finale. We talked about it ahead of time, about what they wanted to get done, how much other stuff they wanted to do, whether they wanted to go ahead and do some of those other things they wanted to turn in, or if they were insignificant due to the fact that if they don't finish this, then, you know, basically the world ends. So they had plenty of time, but in this world, while you're doing side quests and stuff, the bad guys are still doing their stuff, which I put in a lot of things like that, where they would be doing a side quest and run across minions of the big bad evil guy or one of the side, not so, you know, mini bosses, and they would run into those while they're busy doing something else and be like, oh shit. Yeah, we're technically trying to save the world, right? So kind of like, yeah, they were out doing one thing, helping villagers and do something else, and then the real world would kind of peek in every now and then and say, you know, kind of remind them that you guys were doing something before you started helping, you know, get cats out of trees, things like that. So, yeah, I don't railroad my players. If they want to spend, you know, 7 sessions, you know, helping villagers, you know, with their problems, that's totally okay with me. The main plot of the campaign will continue to go on because this is a real world. The bad guys don't stop just because you're busy. Which has led to some interesting character developments for the players themselves, and how they approach things. Yeah, I'm very much a DM that doesn't just run the adventure that the players are doing and ignore the world outside of their little bubble, because I think it's disingenuous to the players who want to have a real immersion. It's kind of like if you were playing, I always talk about games that do that, or kind of like Skyrim, where nothing is going on until you show up. Like, there's absolutely nothing going on in the village. Nobody does anything. No people get slaughtered. The dragon's not there until you get there. Right? So, it's like the world, everything outside of your little zone of influence for the players stops moving until the players get to where they're going. And I feel that's disingenuous to the players who want to be immersed in a world. Yeah, living world concepts. Yeah, absolutely. If they've spent 6 months on a boat, the world should look different when they get off the boat in 6 months. It shouldn't be the same three NPCs standing there like, we have been waiting for you to show up. Here's your quest. You can do that in, you know, if you want to do that, you can play Skyrim or, you know, Elden Ring or something like that, Baldur's Gate, where nothing's going on until you get there. If you want to play in a D&D world that feels lived in, yeah, world building, this world I designed, based on, so, little backstory here. I was a perpetual DM in real life when the plague hit, and couldn't run, a lot of my players. Yeah, they, oh yeah, absolutely. Glorious. Yeah, no, the juicy bits I tend to, toss in, on a regular basis. We do have, you know, the exposition NPCs that show up. Hello, dear.
Hello.
But this world, I started playing, with, DM the Mark Knight, in his world, his homebrew world of Oregon, which myself and a couple other players and DMs helped flesh out some of the backstory for some of his stuff in the past. I started one campaign which didn't finish due to real life issues of a lot of the players, most of which were DMs. So I was running a game on Sunday nights for DMs who didn't get to play. So you can imagine the amount of role playing that went into that game, because, you know, they get to be one person instead of 16 and they can focus on one. But when he took, we were playing, so I started to do this, campaign, which is, basically, this area of the world has been sealed off by a giant time bubble, by an elder dragon, to protect it from outside forces. And it's been that way. So whatever I do here didn't affect his game. He has since stopped streaming and running his 5 games a week, 2 years ago. But we have continued on this, and we're to the point where the players are about ready to either A, win, B, get stomped on, or C, some variation of the thing, because there are 3 different factions plus the PCs who are trying to either A, keep the dragon, who is still here, is trying to keep the barrier still up. There's the evil mage who wants to drain the power from the dragon so he can rule over the land. There's the evil cultists who are trying to free Lord Typhon from his imprisonment in the volcano, which is just about done. And then there's the PCs who are trying to put an end to all of that. Which is why this next session coming up is the culmination of all of that rolling in, bringing in the armies of the giants and the titans and all the people that they've come across to build up this big army to fight against this. The Fae Queen, things of that nature. So this final episode is going to be them escaping the prison that they're in right now, because the Dark Mage has imprisoned them all in a bubble. Escaping that, getting their people together, and arriving on the scene for the final battle, which will be a mostly role playing thing, because to do a fight like that, to give you an example of some, I use Foundry, so to give you an example of some of the avatars here, we'll go to the giant dragon. So here, let's open his character sheet here. Through his biography, make him a little bigger here. This is Tossilduckle the Preserver. He is an ancient elder dragon lord. His attributes are off the chart. He has features that are taken from several other dragons. He's a bronze dragon lord. He is, most of them are going to get lair actions and stuff. This came on the, this is the stat sheet for another dragon. One of the reasons why I like Foundry, is if you want to make, here I'll show you using a regular creature down here. Let's grab ourselves a beast, like a good old fashioned crocodile. I'm really good, because of my, I have a disability. I'm bipolar, ADD, a lot of the dopamine and serotonin, boy problems. But I'm really good at coming up with names. That's one of my gifts. I can sit down and do that. Another hint, I use Google Translate, and I will think of, something that I want the monster to represent, and then I'll go look for different ways of saying that, and say, I'm a big fan of the Nordic and Slavic languages to give you a good feel for that. And sometimes I'll see part of a name that part of a word that seems really cool, and then I'll take another part of another name and just kind of sound it out and write it down and type it out to see if it looks good, if I can pronounce it properly. Yeah, like Welsh is also another great, go to Google Translate. If you want to look for a word, a name, like your instead of saying golden bow for your elves, because a lot of people just say like golden bow, silver hair, bright leaf, go in and find a, Arabic is real good for it. The Slavic language is really good. German's really good. Sometimes I'll use like Maori or Japanese for stuff like for other stuff, especially water type creatures are really good, like the Maori, Hawaiian, stuff like that. That way everything doesn't feel the same. But what I like here is, let's say we're going to create an actor and call it Gator Wolf, if I can spell. I just can't. Gator Wolf, make it a non-player character and put it into Beasts. And I'll create a new actor, and it gives me a character sheet that doesn't look like anything. And then we'll open, and then we can go over here, go to Features, and you can drag and drop features from one monster to another monster. Go up here for the Dire Wolf and do the same thing. And look at the features, and like, I like his bite better than I like this one, so I can remove this bite and toss that bite on there. Give it predatory bearing and pack tactics, because the Gator Wolves travel in a pack. And that's it. Put in some attributes. Actually, I would recommend watching the video summary of how to transfer stuff from Roll20 to Foundry or things like that by Bailey Wiki. You can find his videos on YouTube. Excellent, has a ton of stuff. He also has a Patreon, which I suggest if you are a super DM and want to get a lot out of it, join his Patreon. You'll get a lot of extra stuff. Yeah, Bailey Wiki. Yeah, absolutely. The guy's a genius. he knows more about Foundry than and the modules and stuff like that than anybody else does. He has tons of videos for that and will definitely make your life a lot easier. But yeah, that's how you do it. And then you can just go in here, you can change the damage immunities and say, yeah, they're immune to fire and cold. Now he has immunities of fire and cold. But that's how I do things. Gator Wolf. Okay, I'm going to delete him because I don't actually need a Gator Wolf for this. But yeah, that's just what I do. Like these avatars, there's Slarth the Cath, which is basically kind of a underwater chaos creature. You'll notice that some of these are actually the actual people. Zeratan, Yancy Bin, Maltriga, Boreas. I'll use some of the stuff. There's no need in changing some stuff. There's some stuff to add. Here's some other characters that, the Harbor Master happens to be a turtle. Mad-Eye Mabel, you know, just grab some free, make sure you use either free stuff or people that have the licensing to let you use their art. If you do use art, you know, make sure you always either get the artist's permission, or if they have it posted on the internet, make sure you have acknowledgments otherwise. But today we're actually working on a couple of scenes. Oh my gosh. That one didn't come out well at all. Alright, well, we'll just delete that. Yep, we'll delete it. Here's a great map. Didn't get to use that one, so we can move and toggle navigation. Let's see. Go back to the landing page because I don't need any of these up here. Toggle navigation. Take all these off of here. I need to make a new scene. Finale battlefield. Put it in maps current. And we're going to go and we're going to browse our files. Choose a file. Let's see here. Artwork. Images. Artwork. Maps and landing pages. Label these properly, that I put them in the right. Where did I put them? And this is the biggest problem. Where did I put them? That's the thing that I spend more time looking for my stuff than I do anything else as a DM. Just trying to remember where I put something. There's a great desert. There's Embry. accidentally put them in the character art? Oh, goody. Yeah, part of the problem was finding where I put stuff. So let's go. Definitely have to go searching for stuff. Nope, didn't go there. So it's definitely in here somewhere. I put them in maps. I did put them in maps. Well, okay. Now I know where I remember. Now I just remember which map area did you put them. Because I want a big old map here. Always make it black. Finale battlefield number one. I can figure and take off the grid. And that is the entrance to the what it will look like when the players see the vision or are standing there near the volcano. That is the entrance to the temple for him. And then we make another one. Since I know where I'm going this time. There we go. Take off the grids. Just zoom in so the players can see this. And this is what he will look like when RAR, they show up. Take a look. and see the monster tearing away at everything. He's a elder dragon lord. He is from a different plane of existence. He is approximately 10,000 to 15,000 years old. Him and his mother, the mother dragon, the dragon queen, basically whenever they can, she breaks into a plane. They take over for 1,000 years or so, basically take over the entire plane, live there until they burn out all the resources, and then move on. So they've been doing this for quite a while. he's quite powerful. So, yeah, that's why even at 20th level, with all the help they're going to get, they're not going to be able to kill him. That's just not how the campaign is set up. He's going to be defeated via them, their army, the other things that are trying to kill him, the interplay between the three main bad guys and the PCs are trying to undo something which will have an effect on the final battle, the battle itself. And I need one more here for... spelling is your friend. Finale Battlefield, and we are going to do... which one is this? This is the... the Mage... this one is this one? No, that's the other dragon. It's this one. So this is the horde of zombies and stuff from the evil necromancer mage. And the light from his drawing the power of the heavens to create his zombie army. Now, I do believe I also need to... I need one more. I need a couple more, actually. The Tarrasque. Alphabetical. Grids from here. Yeah, see, that's what a Tarrasque should look like. Not that little hunchback beetle looking thing that they have in a DMG. He should look like a giant kaiju. He should scare the ever loving bejesus out of your party. believe I have one more. If I can spell this correctly. Remember his name. What is his name? Give me a second. I'm trying to remember. Tharza Dune. Dance lessons. Gotta love that. Most of mine are old enough to do what they want, except for the last minion in the house. Oh, I have... my oldest will be... Oh, jeez. 29? This year will be, this coming year will be 29, 27, 25, 19, and my youngest just turned 13 in August. So, yeah, I got a few of them. Yes. Yes, I do. Most of them are out of the house now. So, I'm happy with that. I just have one left. Oh, thanks for the follow, man. I appreciate it. Oh, I totally understand that. My first two were preemies, and the last two were C-sections. So, yeah, I totally understand. Yeah. This is Lord Typhon. Not to configure the size of this stupid thing. Oh, good. Come in.
We're gonna leave soon.
Oh, okay. Love you.
Love you too. Hey. Are you streaming?
Yes, I am.
Nice. Is it Twitch?
Yes.
Hi, Twitch.
Wave hi to Twitch. Okay, not quite what I wanted. better. Oh, it's because I'm being goofy. There we go. Let's take off the grid. Ta-da. Ducks! All the ducks in a row. Alright, there's Lord Typhon. Now for the epilogue. Oh, did I use the wrong pick? Did. That's the one for that, which means that this one is the other one that I was supposed to use. So I should have the landing page, Parsatoon, Lord Typhon, Transplant, Mage, the Dragon, and the Armies. Awesome. Okay. That should be it for that. Set everybody. I won't need them yet. there. Yep, is this the one? And then I need to make an actor. Why I accidentally saved all this stuff in there. It does not need a token. There we go. There's the mage. There's Anders. Alright. Agatha's dead. Upgrade Renata? Is Tiffany going to increase her constitution by 2? Level her up a little bit. No, I don't want to do that. Average. She would take. She has been named. She would learn Fire Bad, Ray of Frost. Why am I doing it the hard way? I was doing it the hard way. Put some decks. Point to wisdom. Point to wisdom. She's an NPC. Alright, she's done. And it should have a moderate waste on. It doesn't matter, but she is brought up to where she needs to be. Go back to here. Now I think I need Tiana's done. Max is done. Diorite is done. Bronco, there's Bork. Had to finish the paladin, who was a PC, who is not here anymore. and due to school cannot join us anymore. Actually, devotion. Okay, I thought so. To get CR to 16. So Puffball should get double that, so 130. Poor Puffball. Okay, Puffball is done. We only have to talk to Darius is dead. Kaz is done. Alright, so I need to bring it to 15. Dadar's done. Overseer's dead. Burning Prince is gone. Thor is dead. Torlon Turk's dead. Vesper's dead. Woon is dead. What else do I need here? Who am I missing? This is the hardest part, trying to remember everybody. Just trying to remember everybody who was to miss a creature. I put somebody in the wrong spot. Oh. I need to bring a creature. I need the Fae Queen. From the Tome of Beasts. So many do I want to use her or do I want to use the Forest Queen? I think it's a There's Tristani as a base. Nah, she's more of a druid. Definitely not Baba Yaga. Yep, it's definitely going to be the... magic. And then I need Moonlit King as well. Friends. There's a princess. One different picture for her. Let me just scroll through the millions and millions of pictures we have to see. There's Tessa Karloff. Nice queen picture. No, too evil looking. There's Minerva. Again. Yeah, just so you know, you can get a lot of free stuff off of the interwebs. Art that you can use. Just make sure it's labeled free use. As most of these are. You can get a lot in the old video game art dumps are good. Scroll through all of these. If you have any questions, I'm more than happy to answer questions for you. Still looks too evil. Not fey enough. Oh, that's a good one. Wizards of the Coast stuff you can use under the licensing stuff. Excellent picture for a cool old monk. More tieflings, more angels, ASMR. I have a fiend queen around here somewhere, don't I? Oh, that's not bad. Not exactly what I'm looking for. Another thing is, don't do what I did. I'm going to have to set this up. I am personally going to have to go back through here and rename all of my stuff because I didn't name it when I was putting it in here. And that is an issue. Because now I can't find stuff, and that's the issue. Ooh, that looks pretty cool. I like that. It's just got a big sword, though. Not sure about having a sword. Because I don't want to get a new picture for her. There's the red side of Avacyn. Some evil slivers. Seneschal, so I can find his picture later. There's the witches. Guy Volgerhouse, Platinum Angel. So, oh yeah, that's the... I always like that picture too, that's so cool. Here's Thalia. What is that? That is a great book of monster. I don't know what it is. Of the Theros gods. Tons of my tokens. Sometimes pictures just end up in here for no apparent reason. My tokens have tokens. use that. Rename her. There we go. Right. Pavlik deserves a face. He's a gnome. We had a big update last year, and a lot of these characters I haven't used in a while ended up losing their token art and creature art for some reason. That for later. No, I don't use that one. No, I might have to. I think Pavel was one of the ones that ended up, I lost the art for him too. I may have to just go ahead and find a different artwork for him. go. Now he's got a real face. Yay. Real face. I don't have much else to do if there's nobody wants to chat. This will be a quick one. we are. Sorry, little time here. I'm people watching some, listening to some of my favorite streams while I'm doing a stream. All right, well, we're going to be done here. Quick hour-long vid. I just needed to make some adjustments, make sure things were going okay. We're going to raid my Thy Fair Lady. Just because she's... we always like to help people out. Give it a few seconds.